Good morning, children. Last class we discussed about the peace and harmony. That was the first class videos we said to you. In the class we have some grammar. See, generally in our houses comparison should be there. If you see your brother is short, means if you compare you, he is shorter than you. So if you compare with your father is taller than you. Actually comparison is there. Some of the people are very fat, some of the people are very lean, and some of them are short. So different kinds of shapes we can see. How we can whichever the words we will use in our daily life, that words have separate names for them. Because we will use different kinds of words for different styles, different situations. So like that, that all words are divided into 8 groups. That 8 groups are called parts of speeches. I am not writing here that all the parts of speeches, because we have in our exercise only one topic, that is adjectives. So first, what are the parts of speeches we will discuss? Parts of speech means the 8 kinds of words. Actually words according to their use divided into 8 parts. That 8 parts are called parts of speech. In the 8 parts, first part is the noun. Noun means nothing but naming word. Any name, place name, person name, any name. Name, it comes under noun. Second one is the pronoun. Pronoun is a word which is used instead of noun. Means pronoun, it we used instead of noun. For example, Ravi is a student. So again, Ravi is studying in the 8th class or in 6th class, we can't say. What simply will say, Ravi is a student, he is studying in the 8th class. So instead of Ravi, second time I used he. So that is, he is the pronoun there. The word which you use instead of noun, it is called pronoun. If you come for the third, adjective. What is an adjective? Adjective is a word which is used to qualify a noun. I said now, Ravi is a tall boy. Means is how it is, he looks physically. He looks physically very tall. And Gopi is a fat boy. How physically he looks? Fat. And rose is a beautiful flower. How the rose it looks like? It looks so beautiful. So in that way, we will use to qualify that noun. See here, tall boy. How that boy is tall. We are qualifying that boy. Physically, how he is, he looks like, that we are expressing there. Because of that, it is called the tall, which the word is there to qualify the boy. It is called an adjective. The word fat, Gopi is a fat boy, we learned. So fat, which is the word using to express about the Gopi, that fat is an adjective. Beautiful flower. Rose is a beautiful flower. Beautiful, whichever the word is that, it is using to qualify the flower. Because of that, beautiful is the adjective. After, if you come verb. Verb is a word, it denotes an action. To express our actions, we are using verb. After, if it comes adverb. Adverb is a word, it qualifies an adjective, a verb, and another adverb. So here, adverb, it has more work because it has to do 3 kinds of verbs. Some of the time, it qualifies an adjective. Some of the times, it qualifies a verb. And some of the times, it qualifies itself. So it has 3 verbs. After, if it comes preposition. Preposition is a word that it connects the word, it connects the noun to other parts of the verb. Other parts of the sentence, sorry. Other parts of the sentence, the preposition it connects. One example I will say. I am going to school. School is a verb, that noun. School is a word, it indicates the noun. That school noun is connected to the remaining part of the sentence, that is I am going. I am going, where I am going? I am going to school. To is the preposition. It is used to connect a noun to other parts of the sentence. So, like that, preposition we will use. After that, if we come conjunction. Conjunction means some of the time more words we want to write. For example, in that Peace and Harmony, we wrote that elephants, bees, bears, tigers, and peacocks. See, lot of words are there. Comma, comma, comma. We will keep and we will write all the different words. And when we use it to add the words, we can use the connectors. That connectors is and, that is called conjunction. To add two words, to add two sentences, to add two phrases, to add two clauses. So differently, if we want to add both of them, for that we need one connection. That connection is called conjunction. So we will connect there. Next, interjection. Interjection is nothing but our strong feelings. Some of the time we will feel sad, some of the time we will feel happy. So that all expressions we will show in interjection. So like that, noun, pronoun, verb, adjective, adverb, preposition, conjunction, interjection. Totally 8 parts of speeches are there. In that 8 parts of speech, very important and very useful to us, that is the adjective. Why I am saying very useful means, because we can impress other person by, means praising him. For praising other person, we should want to use this adjective. So, adjective is very important, and adjective is a word which qualifies a noun. And it says about the color, size and taste, so many things out there. That all comes under this adjective. Actually, in our exercise, he used this adjective for the comparison purpose. Here, 3 types of comparisons out there. See, one is a positive degree, second one is a comparative degree, third one is a superlative degree. If only one is there, means that we can compare positively. You are a good boy. You are a good boy. That's enough. There is no other person. So, we are using you are a good boy and you are a tall boy. So, your height we are comparing, but no other person is there to compare you with that person. Only alone you are. We are using only one person. So, we are using positive degree. You are a tall boy. Second, comparative degree. 2 persons are there. Gopi and Ravi is there. Gopi is taller than Ravi. Because 2 persons we want to compare. When 2 persons we want to compare, we want to use comparative degree. If only Gopi is there, Gopi is a tall boy. Again with the Gopi, Ramesh is there. Gopi is taller than Ramesh. Because Ramesh is shorter than this Gopi. So, for that, we will use comparative degree. If 2 persons are there, so comparing the 2 persons, we want to use comparative degree. Second one, if it comes, superlative degree. Superlative means among all the group of people, one class is there. For example, your 6th class. In your 6th class, 60 children are studying in one room. Then, among that all the 60 people, Suresh is the person that is a good student. So, what we can say, Suresh is the best person in this class. Only among all the people, nearly 60 people are there, among that 60 children, only Suresh is the best. See, the best student in the class. More of, means after that Suresh, no one is eligible. Only Suresh is eligible for that quality. So that is superlative degree. So here again I am explaining, positive degree means only one thing we want to compare. Comparative degree means among two things we have to compare. Superlative degree means among some of the things, a group of things we want to collect. In that group of things we want to take one. That is superlative degree. These are the some of the words in your textbook he gave in the page number 8. Positive degree, comparative degree and superlative degree. Some of the words he gave. After that, one passage is there. In that passage, you have to underline the adjectives which he gave in that passage. Down of that passage, opposite words are there. That opposite words, you have to read and you have to learn. After the opposite words, one more bit, second bit it is opposite words and fill in the blanks are there. That fill in the blanks you have to do yourself. So do that. And so after that, if we come to 11th page, there are again fill in the blanks are there. That is about by using never, often, seldom, sometimes. Using that words, we have to fill that words. So do that exercises. Exercise number page number 8 to 11. Whichever the exercises are there, that all exercises you have to do in your house. So do that. Don't neglect. Stay home. Stay safe. Thank you.